All that you have done to us, O Lord, you have done with true judgment, for we have sinned against you and not obeyed your commands. But give glory to your name and deal with us according to the bounty of your mercy. In the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You raise the dead to life in the Spirit, Lord, have mercy. You bring pardon and peace to the sinner, Christ, have mercy. You bring light to those in darkness, Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who manifest your almighty power above all by pardoning and showing mercy, bestow, we pray, your grace abundantly upon us, and make those hastening to attain your promises heirs to the treasures of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. A reading from the book of Job. One day, when the angels of God came to present themselves before the Lord, Satan also came among them. And the Lord said to Satan, "Whence do you come?" Satan answered the Lord and said, "From roaming the earth and patrolling it." And the Lord said to Satan, "Have you noticed my servant Job, and that there is no one on earth like him, blameless and upright, fearing God and avoiding evil?" But Satan answered the Lord and said, "Is it for nothing that Job is God-fearing? Have you not surrounded him and his family and all that he has with your protection? You have blessed the work of his hands, and his livestock are spread all over the land. But now put your hand and touch anything that he has, and surely he will blaspheme you to your face." And the Lord said to Satan, "Behold, all that he has is in your power. Only do not lay a hand upon his person." So Satan went forth from his presence from the Lord. And so one day, while his sons and daughters were eating and drinking wine in the house of their eldest brother, a messenger came to Job and said, "The oxen were plowing, and the asses grazing beside them, and the Sabaeans carried them off in a raid. They put the herdsmen to the sword, and I alone have escaped to tell you." While he was yet speaking, another came and said, "Lightning has fallen upon from heaven and struck the sheep and their shepherds and consumed them, and I alone have escaped to tell you." While he was yet speaking, another messenger came and said, "The Chaldeans formed three columns, seized the camels, carried them off, and put those tending them to the sword, and I alone have escaped to tell you." While he was yet speaking, another came and said, "Your sons and daughters were eating and drinking wine in the house of your eldest brother, when suddenly a great wind came across the desert and smote the four corners of the house. It fell upon the young people, and they are dead. And I alone have escaped to tell you." Then Job began to tear his cloak and cut off his hair. He cast himself prostrate on the ground and said, "Naked I came forth from my mother's womb, and naked shall I go back again. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord." In all this, Job did not sin, nor did he say anything disrespectful of God. The word of the Lord. Incline your ear to me and hear my word. Incline your ear to me and hear my word. Hear, O Lord, a just suit. Attend to my outcry. Hearken to my prayer from lips without deceit. Incline your ear to me and hear my word. From you let my judgment come. Your eyes behold what is right. Though you test my heart, searching it in the night, though you try me with fire, you shall find no malice in me. Incline your ear to me, hear my word. I call upon you, you will answer me, O God. Incline your ear to me and hear my word. Show your wondrous mercies, O Savior of those who flee, from their foes to refuge at your right hand. Incline your ear to me, O God, and hear my word. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. An argument arose among the disciples about which of them was the greatest. Jesus realized the intention of their hearts and took a child and placed it by his side and said to them, "Whoever receives this child in my name receives me, and whoever receives me receives the one who sent me. For the one who is least among all of you is the one who is the greatest." Then John said in reply, "Master, we saw someone casting out demons in your own name. We tried to prevent them, because he does not follow in our company." Jesus said to him, "Do not prevent him, for whoever is not against you is for you." The Gospel of the Lord. Well, if you ever wonder if God, the creator of the heavens and the earth, and Satan were to have a conversation, this is exactly what we heard in the first reading today. We have a man named Job who seems to have a perfect life. He's got all the livestock he needs. He has daughters and sons. He has everything. And Satan comes along from patrolling and roaming the earth and talks to the Lord and says, "You know, if you allow me to work on Job a little bit and to give him some suffering, which is major suffering from what I could see, losses of sons and daughters, losses of livestock, losses of everything almost, the Lord permitted it. The Lord permitted the suffering." We can look at this year of 2020 and maybe sufferings in our own life from years past, things that have happened in our lives where things have been taken away from us that the Lord has blessed us with, or people have been taken away from us that the Lord has blessed us with. Job finished the first reading today. It says that the Lord gave and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So no matter what happens in my life, I still know that the Lord is Lord, and I still know that he is God. And to notice the relationship between Satan and God as well is the Lord permitted Satan to give Job afflictions and to give Job suffering. But he put limits on it. He says you have to spare his life. You can't lay a hand on him. And so God has the devil on a sort of a leash. God's always in control. And he can loosen that leash, and he can bring it back as well. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Everything is in control of the Lord. And so what we're called to do is to look at our sufferings and look at the losses that have happened in my life, and I still have to say that the Lord has blessed me with those things, and it's not mine to have forever. And that's a very difficult thing to think about. It's a very difficult thing to sometimes let go of. We can't do it alone. We have to do it with the help of God. And so today we ask the Lord for healing. We ask the Lord for healing in our suffering. We ask the Lord to help us to detach, maybe from the things of people of this world, not in a way that we want to forget about them, but we detach from them by noticing that they're blessings in our life, but they're not meant to be a blessing in my life as I know it forever. So I call to offer myself to the Lord. I'm called to give of myself to Him, and blessed be His name, blessed be the name of the Lord. With humble and faithful hearts, we call upon the Lord, that God may continue to look graciously upon His holy church, fill her people with spiritual gifts and graces. Let us pray to the Lord. For our elected officials and those to be elected, may they do the will of God with their whole heart, mind, soul, and strength. Let us pray to the Lord. For our young men and women seeking their vocation in life, may they turn and answer the Lord with courage. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who are suffering from loss and hardship, may they look to Job as a model today. Let us pray to the Lord. For those that have died, may they find lasting peace at God's right hand in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord. This afternoon's Mass intention is Gerard McCormick, and for the prayers held in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord. Merciful God, incline your ear to us and hear and answer our prayers this day, which we bring to you through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, and my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant us, O merciful God, that this our offering may find acceptance with you, and through it the wellspring of all blessing may be laid open before us, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift. Since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so, in the company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Lawrence, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom of God. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy of your shepherd, but only say the word. Remember your word to your servant, O Lord, by which you have given me hope. This is my comfort when I am brought low. For communion, again, we'll be back to going back towards the wall, the stations of the cross, make one line. Be careful of the yellow caution sign right there. There's a grate with no grate, actually, so we want to be very careful, and we'll help go back the way of the pillars. Our act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself fully to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. May this heavenly mystery, O Lord, restore us in mind and body, that we may be co-heirs in glory with Christ, to whose suffering we are united, whenever we proclaim his death, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Last couple of weekends, I've been reappointed 5 more years as vocation director, and so with that comes a change in residence as well. And so I'll be going to St. Jude sometime, so my last mass here will be Wednesday, but I might be popping over every once in a while as well, too. So I just want to thank you. You've kind of been my congregation the last couple of years. Normally I do the 12:10 mass, and so pray for me. I'll be praying for you. It'll only be a couple miles away, so pray for vocations and continue to pray for each other. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.